Hello all. Today we are back with another review.
Another Iranian movie.
Yes.
It's like Iranian month going on for us because we are watching one after another and we can't just get enough of them.
Yeah. We are going to do Taste of Cherry.
1997 by Abbas.
Kiarostami.
Yeah.
But before that, we would like to review a short picture, short Iranian film that runs to about 22 minutes.
It's more like a documentary by Farooq.
More like an awareness film, we can say.
Yeah. So it talks about leprosy and it's shown how leprosy was in Persia. And so this movie is about a leper colony. So we have these amazing, heart-touching scenes in the movie. Like it starts with a woman who's probably about to get married. So she's getting dressed up. And her eye, one of her eye is damaged because of, it has been affected. And so they show a lot of such scenes which are very heart touching, like a woman, putting on mascara where it goes so deep because the skin is dead, almost dead. And, carving out the dead skin out of people's body, people trying to.
What people do, how people live with leprosy. I mean, it's they talk about how it is a disease and it is not incurable. It can be cured. But at that point of time, people were mostly isolated. I mean, those who have been diagnosed with leprosy have always been just isolated. And
so they had no contact with people outside.
Yes.
And I think that kind of brings them down more.
So this more talks about how they lead lives and Farooq Saad, the whole thing, there are no dialogues in this movie. They just make...
There's a narration of Quran going on.
The Quran and the Bible and the Old Testament and Farooq's own poetry. She talks about how these people are being... ostracized because of this disease and how they are trying to get some meaning to live.
So the whole point, there are a few dialogues that are at the last. You know, there is this teacher who's teaching almost the whole demography that lives there, from kids to these old people. And so he asks, okay, what are the beautiful things in your life? And the kid answers the sun, the moon, all the beauty in the world, okay? Yes. That's how he portrays. And another kid is asked, what is ugly in this life? And he says, hands, legs,
head.
And I mean, he was talking about himself, being ugly because of being affected.
Yeah.
And, at that point of time, if a kid thinks that way, it just leaves you, speechless.
What future holds for them? I mean, there is absolutely nothing, I guess. I mean, unless and until they are cured, they are affected. The childhood has been dropped from them because of this disease.
And even if they are not affected, probably these things are mostly permanent.
Yeah.
They will never be accepted in
society.
Society. So, and last, it ends with a person being asked to make a sentence about house.
Yeah.
And that's how they close the... doors to the leper colony saying the house is black, and that's how the picture, right? So it was, I think, it was one of the greatest movie ever made at that time.
Yes.
And it's just 22 minutes, and it is actually, this shows all of the Iranian cinema how they have been showing suffering over and over again. Yeah, they have been concentrating on this thing, no matter the world is getting advanced. With
suffering and its relation to God. I mean,
there is no fantasy in their life, it's all reality. Whatever people are facing and how they are acting in their real life. Most of the movies, if you see, people are just doing their daily chores.
Yeah.
That is how they are filmed. So, coming to our movie, The Taste of Cherry. I mean, I personally loved this movie. I think because of the ending, but so we would like to discuss about it.
We're not shown exactly the motive of the person. The main character is Humayun Arshadi, who's playing Badi. He's a taxi driver and he's just going around. We are shown, you know, this picture is known for its distance shots. I mean, there are, they show a lot of landscapes and people. I mean, how the place has been chosen for this movie. So we are shown Badi, he's a taxi driver in somewhere in Iran, and he's just shown talking to people.
He seemed to be needing few people for some work.
So he's trying to entice people for a job, basically.
So initially, what hits your mind is maybe he's taking out to, you know, kill them, or maybe he's homosexual or something. But then he ends up taking the soldier. This is the first person he takes in his taxi, and he takes him to the place. And the person has, you know, he has his own doubts, and he gets scared. Why? Where is he taking him? And this is the job he assigns him. He's like, you have to do one thing. You have to come here at 6 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, and you shout Badi twice. And if I, you know, if I respond, you give me your hand, you pull me out of a hole that is in the tree near. Or if I do not, you put 20 spades of earth on top of me. And and that's how, and you can take the money that's in the car. And that is, I think it's a lot of money that is shown there.
So we are shown a soldier first, who is a training soldier, and he seems to, I mean, like whomsoever he meets, Badi tries to make the, I mean, like whether they are having any difficulty regarding money and whether you want any money, so that he can convince them to do the job. So this soldier is slightly, is very young, and he has suffered a lot, and he's a Kurd from Kurdistan, and he has been a farmer. So they try to just, so Badi tries to convince this soldier that it's nothing, just think that you are farming. So it's like he's reluctant,
and he says that I cannot bury you alive. So he denies the whole thing and he just runs away. So Badi has to, it seems Badi needs someone to bury him. Inside, and I think that shows how Iranian people are
still,
you know, people commit suicide all over the world, and not even, you know, they don't need an accomplice for that. But I think he wants himself to rest in peace and never to be looked for or found again.
So, the soldier flees, and then he goes to this construction site where he is just sitting.
So this excavation work is being carried out. So he meets this seminarist, and
so first he meets a guy who's picking trash. So he doesn't seem to be really concerned. Then he meets a soldier, and then he sees.
Despite of all the poverty and hard life that they have, they're not ready to do anything for money. Okay. This is another aspect that the movie is trying to show. I think if probably someone would have asked this in a developed country or something, I don't think people would have thought twice about it.
The amount of money he was offering was quite high. So anyone, it's just go and bury the body and go back.
So he takes the seminarist, and the conversation between them takes place. And he tries to talk him out of it, saying that, you know, suicide is wrong, as mentioned in the commandments and everything. And, you know, killing is wrong, and killing oneself. So that means killing oneself is also wrong.
Yes.
So he sees that, you know, this is not going to work out. So he just drops him off. So we have a winner here. We get, he meets a taxidermist. And who he's
agrees.
Given the ride. And before that, just before he wants, he's giving up, you know. He's just trying to seduce people to come there, and it's not working. So he looks at this excavation place and he thinks, I mean, it might work out. That's
so
what,
he sees the soil going under and getting crushed or something. So he was just sitting
and
there.
And he might be never found there.
Once
but there was something about the tree that he holds on to, you know, he wants to be buried there. Maybe it's a place of peace, because excavation site, come on, you know, don't want to be dead.
So when
there.
He talks to the
taxidermist,
and before that he talks to the security guard, he says, I mean, what, this place is so peaceful, to which the taxidermist says, this is nothing but dust. So there is something about being getting a proper burial, probably. So he doesn't go inside the machine. He just gets the taxidermist. So, and they have a conversation.
Yeah, they have an amazing conversation. So yeah. Before having the conversation itself, this guy, taxidermist, has agreed to do this for him.
Yes.
Because he thinks if anyway he's going to go ahead, he should get a proper burial. And kind of he needs the money because his son is not well.
Yes.
But he wanted to convince him one last time.
Yes.
So there goes his story about him, you know, attempting a suicide once.
So he goes, he's in an unhappy marriage. And then what happens is he calls it, that's it. This is the end. And he takes his car, goes away somewhere. And
he wants to hang himself
with some rope.
Yeah. So he
climbs a tree.
Yeah, that's a mulberry tree.
Yeah.
And as he ties the knots, he sees the sun coming up and he eats a mulberry.
Yeah.
And then there are these kids who come around and they're asking him to, you know,
drop some mulberries.
Drop a few more mulberries. And at that point of time, he had a change of heart.
Yeah.
Okay. And the mulberries really made him happy. So he decided.
He changed his mind.
Otherwise, and he went back to his wife with. Mulberries.
And he tries to convince the taxi driver that it didn't change, the life didn't change. It was just the way it was. But still, he had something to hold on to.
And the protagonist is never been shown to, you know, be narrating his problems.
Yes.
No, he has never said what exactly is he suffering from, which is that bad, you know, he can't talk about it. And he has just decided that he wants to do this.
Someone with 2 lakh tomans or whatever would not actually have any issues with money as such. So probably he's just frustrated with life or something.
We don't
just
know that.
Yeah.
This guy, he tries to tell him that would you... He tries to show him, you know, that there's just too much beauty to quit.
Yes.
And that's when the dialogue comes that, you know, do you not want the taste of cherries?
So the taxidermist tries hard to convince him, and he's not replying. The taxi driver does not talk much.
But so, he is listening to him.
Yes. And after that, he goes sees the sunset, and then he goes back to the taxidermist to say that, like, if just hit me with 3 stones.
Yeah, that was a real change of, you know, his
really alive.
Ideas. Yeah. It was like he would be doing this because he has thought about it for a while.
Yes.
And it would be wrong to not go ahead with it. But then he was like, maybe what if I change my mind? I just slept off at night.
Yeah.
So could you just try to wake me up, you know, shake my shoulder or something.
So the characters chosen have been in such a way that they were probably related with it in some way or the other. Like the Kurdish to whom he says, you have suffered a lot in your life. You have seen all these things.
And you are supposed to kill people without giving it a second thought. So how can you do, you know, not kill me?
Yes.
It should be easy for you.
And then the second is the Afghani guy who's a refugee as such from... because of the
war.
Yeah. So these were people who were supposed to be hardened against such form of things, such like seeing death in its true form. But still, they are reluctant to give up their morals and just bury him if he's dead and just pick him out if he's alive. And yeah.
And you see, when the last time that the taxidermist and the protagonist they meet, taxidermist was very sure that this guy has changed his mind. Somehow, I felt that way because he wasn't that, you know, he was no longer convincing him.
Mm.
And he just knew that I think he has done enough. But then we see that the guy goes back and we are not shown him taking the sleeping pills, but he's on his way. He goes to the tree.
Yeah.
And there's a thunderstorm that day.
Yes.
And he lies beneath. It's an amazing scene. Okay.
Yeah.
So he has prepared everything. He just has to go inside.
Yes.
And his face is only he doesn't want to be suffocated, I think.
Yes, so the face is exposed.
Yeah. So, and that's where they show the knight occurs. At this point of time, like, it's 1 or 2 minutes, okay? And we're just waiting what's going to happen next. You know, the first thing that came into my mind was maybe all three arrive.
Yeah.
Or maybe nobody arrived. Okay.
Yes.
Maybe the third one thought that he wouldn't, you know, he was so convinced that the person would not come there. And so he doesn't have to go there. Anyway, we can see that he doesn't really need the money.
Yes.
And we also don't know if the guy actually stayed there the whole night, you know.
Or did he take the pills or not?
Yeah, he never did. He just stayed there to enjoy, you know, the night or the beauty of the night.
I'll probably come and see who's coming there for the money. Probably the money never existed for all we know.
Oh, I never thought so, but yeah, that's a...
Just a study of the human behavior, probably. We don't know.
Yeah. So we see him doing that, and we are dying off to know what happens. And that's when they just cut the movie, and you know, they just break the fourth wall, and we are shown all the cameras and the crew. You know, they are all the cast. You know, they are just,
we are shown
just
soldiers
themselves
who are happy. So the when people acting as soldiers.
So. What comes to my... First of all, this movie has been criticized by a lot of people.
Yes.
Okay. Actually, including Roger Ebert. Yeah. And how do you feel about this movie? Because this was totally my choice. I asked him, like, we are going to do this movie, you know. So you watch it and let's do it. Because I personally loved it.
It's a good movie. It's an excellent movie in terms of... just because they don't show the end, people probably got a bit...
No, he called this movie, like, it's very boring too.
Yeah.
That's kind of hurtful. I don't know. I mean...
considering if you have a flair for Iranian movies, I mean, it's a minimalist movie, first of all. I mean, it doesn't have many characters. It doesn't have any...
All they have got is dialogue and this great idea, which, I mean, how they bring it, I don't know. Okay, every movie has this amazing idea and it's such a small thing. They took the suicide thing and they made
something out of it.
Exactly. They made a thriller out of it. You know, at the end of it, you just wanted to know, oh my God, what happened next?
It's a beautiful movie as such. I mean, it's just a man trying to get, you know, trying to just finish off his life, and people come and try to convince him otherwise.
He just made his last day very exciting and, you know, interesting, even if he died. I think we are going to, I mean, this, they just keep me, you know, watching more of this, the Iranian movies.
Yes. Probably we'll go the whole gamut, we'll finish it off.
Yeah.
All the other Iranian movies.
I mean, we haven't seen all, so at this point of time, we don't know how many more we are going to do. You know, even the good ones, all we know are the good ones because they come in some post or some article. We try to watch it, but I really love the movie. And so no criticism for the movie from us. And
it's an excellent movie in terms of human behavior. Probably the end, people would have
the
loved
whole
to see
cinema
an end.
Is
yeah, people would have loved to see an end probably, but then it robs the whole charm of it.
I know you've at that point of time I was disheartened, but then I thought, isn't that amazing, you know, just to leave it for us.
Yes.
Think
what is he gonna do next.
And the protagonist is also shown later. So
he's alive.
As an impossible movie, so you need never know. Okay, amazing movie. I think you will love it. I mean, you have watched it.
Yeah.
So keep watching Iranian movies. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.